I was in a subway the other day. This guy screams across the tracks. Screams across the tracks. He goes, "Yo, Monica! Yo, Monica! Yo, you got AIDS, yo!" And I thought, wow, that's how they tell you? That Michael Moore is right. We have the worst fucking healthcare system. Up in Canada, they call you up probably, right? Maybe an email or something. They don't just hire a Puerto Rican kid to scream across the tracks. What kind of shitty way is that to get health news? Yo, Greg, your cholesterol's high, son. Thank you, Hector.
Scotty doesn't know that Fiona and me do it in my van every Sunday. She tells him she's in church, but she doesn't go. Still, she's on her knees, and Scotty doesn't know. Oh, Scotty doesn't know.
Welcome to the Nightmare with ScottyVia. I am your host, ScottyVia. Follow me on Twitter at ScottyVia. The trifecta right there.
ScottyVia.
Yeah. How are you, Date Night?
I am pretty good, old friend. How are you doing?
I'm fantastic. Stetts, how you doing, pal?
I'm great.
Oh, you sound great. I don't know why I grunted right before that.
Yeah, I don't know.
Like kind of homoerotic.
Master P video.
Yeah. Guys, before we get into our weekends, I do have an update from last week.
Uh-oh.
I talked about a waitress.
Oh, yeah.
Who I had called, no answer. I had text, no answer. Come Thursday, my workday's almost done. I got a little feeling, a little vibration in the old pants.
Uh-oh.
It's my cell phone.
Oh, okay. That's different.
I got a text message from said waitress.
Oh.
Yes, I'm thinking Marky Mark there for a second. Was it good or was it bad?
Here's what it says. I'm going to read it verbatim. You got it?
Oh, verbatim. My favorite word.
Here we go. So the text says, "Yes, I remember you too. And I'm happy that book added some value. Thank you, Scott. If you have any more questions, please feel free to ask. I have a book list that the richest people in the world read. Smiley face. And I'm in contact with them every day."
What?
Yeah.
Hold on. Is that not like the biggest humble brag I've ever heard in my life?
Or she's cuckoo for Cocoa Puffs.
Yeah.
Man, like, is she hanging out with Buffett and
Oprah?
Trump and the boys or what?
I don't know. I'll be on. I haven't responded back yet.
Oh.
And it's been days, but she took days to get back to me, so I'm okay with this.
Yeah.
What do I do with that? What do I do with that?
Throw it in the garbage.
Corey, you know. Gary, you
yeah.
know.
Yeah,
I can usually talk my way into any situation or out of any situation.
Yep.
At least I can adapt to it or somewhat understand it. I can't. I don't know what to do with this one.
This is really interesting.
Yeah, I almost want to text her back and be like, "So what do rich people read?"
Did the $1 million man write this?
Yeah,
maybe she's secretly like a conduit to the $1 million man in some way.
She's the one that coined the phrase, "Everyone's got a price."
Oh, wow.
Wow, there you go.
Yeah. I don't know, call me crazy, but this is ridiculous.
That is crazy. Crazy.
That
is ridiculous crazy.
First things first, she definitely does not want to have sex with me.
I think we can all agree to that, yeah.
Yes.
Does she have a book that she's writing or something?
That's literally all I know. That's all I know is what that text message said.
Really, really proud of her book collection.
I guess, but that could mean anything. That could be like, "Oh, I get a newsletter once a week from Rich Dick Digest." I don't know.
I thought I was the only one who subscribed to that.
I don't know. So, again, if anyone has any idea what I should do, tweet me at ScottyVia and let me know what I should do, because I don't know. I'm not going to reply unless I actually get replies back.
You know, you could send her something in the way of, "This is all nice and stuff, but how do you feel about me and you doing stuff together?"
Direct.
Yeah, but what if she wants me to read?
That's fine.
No, I'm like, sure, it's not fine. The most I've ever read is this text message. That's the farthest I've ever gotten in reading.
No.
You've read instruction manuals for video games.
That is true.
And I guarantee you've done way worse things than read to pick up a girl.
You don't want to know.
Exactly.
So
I think a little bit of reading probably won't throw you off too much, buddy.
This is what I'm going to do. Since she knows rich people, I'm going to be like, so you must know my friend Brett Favre. And then send a dick pic. Dick pic.
I think that would probably both make you the greatest man of all time and the worst.
Not worse than Brett Favre, though.
Well, yeah, because you're using his format to try to get your way. But
and his foreskin. Ba-doom.
He's a trendsetter.
Yeah, so you'd be basically biting his style, which is never good.
Yeah, it's true. So, yeah, tweet me at ScottyVia. If you listen to this on my Facebook page, do it there. Also, fun little I forgot to mention last week, I think. I'm putting the shows up on YouTube.
Very fun.
So feel free to comment there as well. Love it. But I'm trying to get all the older shows on there, but I'm also going to be uploading the show on YouTube weekly. It takes an extra day to do it because uploading shit to YouTube is stupid slow. So I'll put the show up on Podomatic Wednesday, like usual, and then it should be up by Thursday night on YouTube. So I've gotten good feedback on that as well. I don't know if anyone ever uses it, but a lot of people said it's a good idea.
Agreed.
So just Absolutely. YouTube The Nightmare with ScottyVia and you'll find it.
Hooray.
Date night, how was your weekend?
It was good.
Perfect. Corey, yours?
Super dee duper.
This is the nightmare. Oh, I'm kidding. Oh, Scott. Gary, go ahead. Oh.
I literally it was a good weekend. You know, lots of nice stuff happened and
crushed some puss?
No, none of that. Mania happened and the last couple of years, you guys, I'll let you on a little secret. I've ordered Mania at my house.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And always coincided with that was a bucket of KFC chicken.
Of course. Bird.
This year, wasn't at my house.
Boo.
No KFC chicken.
And boo.
Of course, the taker happened. I don't even know how to explain it. It was blamed on me because it wasn't at my house and there wasn't a bucket of chicken.
You broke the streak.
I broke the streak.
I hate you.
That was the worst part of my weekend. But the best part of my weekend was I broke the streak with friends. So...
I had a couple different options to go to somebody's house to watch Mania, but I was like, no, this is the... what's up?
You a stud.
A bit of a social butterfly.
I guess so.
but I refused.
Okay.
If this is the biggest show of the year for me, I want to be comfortable in my own home and just watch it. If I want to lay down on my couch, I'm going to lay down.
The granddaddy of them all.
Exactly, right? I just like being comfortable. And, yeah. So that's why I had a buddy come over. And actually, Cote, you've heard him on the show a few times. Gary, you haven't.
Okay.
But replaced you while you were out for a few couple shows.
No one can replace Damon.
Oh, stop.
Replace the essence.
No. There's no replacement. He stepped in during an absence. No replacement.
Substitute batter?
Carry on host.
Is that, did I say that right?
He could pinch it, sure.
There it is.
Yeah, he came to watch TV with me.
That's awesome. I'm still blushing from those compliments.
Get a room, you fucks. Corey, how was your weekend?
It was awesome. I went and saw Cap, Captain America.
You did?
Soldier. Yes.
Really?
Second time in as many days.
Wow.
Yeah, bit of a fanboy.
How was it?
I loved the shit out of it. Probably one of the best movies I've seen. Just stepping away from it, a Marvel movie,
yeah.
Stepping away from a sequel. It's probably, as a sequel, it's probably one of the best sequels I've ever seen.
Yes.
And it's... by far, I feel, the best Marvel movie out there.
So good. Do you remember that part where I came with you?
Yes.
Yeah, I do.
Yeah, that was awesome. And remember the part when you didn't come to watch Mania with me?
Oh.
Yeah.
That was awesome.
You wanted
awesome.
To wear a John Cena shirt, and I didn't allow that.
And then so Sunday, went to and watched Mania. So my friend is a huge Cena hater. So I had this elaborate idea of buying a Cena shirt, headbands and everything. I was going to call his wife ahead of time and say, okay, hit his music and I'll come running through the front door and I'll come and stand in his face and salute and everything. Couldn't find anything in this amazing city of ours.
Is it still amazing if you can't find a decent wrestling shirt?
It ruined my spot.
Ooh.
There you go.
Well, that's why God made the internet, boys. We all know that.
Exactly.
Yeah, but when you plan late, it doesn't help.
Yeah.
Well, it's not up to the city to make sure you guys remember to do awesome shit.
It'd exactly. be nice if they accommodated every now and then, though.
I've got something cooking, as The Rock would say.
Oh.
Okay, so... I think it's safe to say we all watch WrestleMania this weekend.
Yes.
Agreed.
Corey, I'm going to start with you.
Okay.
Out of 10, what do you give the show?
Ooh, out of 10? I'm going to go hard on it. I'm going to go 6.5
wow.
or 7 out of 10.
Oof.
It's not my favorite Mania.
Date night?
I was the same way.
Really?
Right off the bat, I was so pumped. when Hogan, and then of course he, the Silver Dome, and then I was like, oh, did
that? That's awesome. I'm shaking my head like okay, Silver Dome three times.
Nice.
Yeah. So then when Stone Cold came, I was like, okay, well, this is already the best Mania ever.
Yep.
And then Rock came, I was like, okay, well, now it's the best Mania ever.
Yep.
And then seeing Triple H come out in his Skyrim outfit, like straight up Dragonborn, it was so sweet. Oh, awesome.
That's the best gimmick right there.
Yep.
So good.
Amazing.
And then the match was incredible. And then everything just sort of went downhill for me for a while. And then I was like, okay, well, Taker's going to bring me back. And I got excited again. And then that happened. And then I couldn't even enjoy the Lumberjill match because I was just so distraught. I didn't know what to do. Wrestling literally ruined my faith in humanity.
Your boner.
I was so angry and sad. I don't know what to feel. And then the finish was what everyone expected. So I'd say I'd probably give it, like, that's maybe a 6. Just because the awesome points are really awesome, but the low points, like having Hacksaw and Slaughter and Ricky the Dragon doing their little commercial there for the toys and stuff.
Dangerous Danny Davis.
Yeah, Simmons was awesome though with the dam, right?
Of course.
That was good. But like stupid shit like that was going on. Like it seemed there was all the way through the show, and it really threw me off. It's just, you gotta work these guys better than that. And it's a 6. I'll stop rambling. 6.
All right,
Scotty.
I'm not going to compare it to other Manias. I'm just going to take it for what it is. The show that we watched last night, the storylines building up to it, just my enjoyment and the shock factor of everything. I'm going to give it an 8.
Wow.
Just because we saw something we never thought we'd ever see, whether we agree with it or not. It was still one of the most shocking moments in the history of wrestling. We saw a guy that probably, in reality, according to some, should never be in the main event of WrestleMania, wrestle twice. And put on a 5-star match each time.
Now, you're a huge wrestling fan, Scotty. Yep. Is this the first time a little person's held the title?
No.
What, you mean Dink? Joyce buddy there never won it?
I don't know.
I love midgets.
I know. That's where this is going.
But, you know, in this day and age, they just like the big jacked up dudes. So, and the guy put on a great show twice.
Well,
and then you've got Taker losing, biggest moment ever in WrestleMania history probably. Biggest shocker anyway. You mix in Cesaro being a fucking beast in the Battle Royal.
Yeah, see, that's another thing that I was sort of disappointed with.
What?
Well, just the whole starting everyone in the ring with the Battle Royal.
That's a Battle Royal, though.
So I know that's how it works, but, like, you can't even see what's happening for the first 10 minutes.
Go take a dump.
I thought it was really going to be a Royal Rumble, not a Battle Royal.
Everyone else was thinking. I had to correct people, but I still
part-time
thought
fans
awesome.
Then.
No, I just thought. I didn't. You know, I saw Battle Royal. I just was like, no, I want to see.
Yeah.
If you want to impress me, do your spin thing with Paul White, okay? That'll impress me.
It did impress you that he picked him up almost Hulk Hogan, Andre the Giant-esque?
No, that was pretty cool, but spin him. If you're going to be a man. Don't go half man.
Yeah. I wanted to see spin on.
You guys have too high expectations.
Oh, sorry. No.
But we did.
That was an amazing moment. He picked up a 450-pound guy and put him over the top rope. He's not a jack dude. Like, he's just a legit strong man.
Well, there's reports that people say he is. Mark Henry has actually said he is the strongest man in the WWE.
Exactly. And to pick a guy up, he's already done the swing on the Great Khali.
Yeah.
So I've seen him swing a big
man.
Then
do it to the Big Show.
Maybe Big Show didn't want it.
Well, maybe Big Show doesn't help the show.
If you do the Big Show swing, then you got to pick him up, and then you're going to slam him over the top rope. That's two big moves, and one's going to take away from the other.
Well, if you're pushing that character...
which they are.
Then that helps develop.
I think that body slam was quite the moment. Quite the moment.
Okay.
It came out of nowhere, and the crowd popped so big for it.
Okay.
So you got an 8.
That's why it's an 8. Yeah. I got a 6.
Yeah, I got 6.5.
All right.
I hope that's not wiener size. That'd be totally different. I'd be like way lower.
Yuck. I was very happy with the show. I watched it live, then I watched a little bit of the replay, and then I stood up all night watching the Hall of Fame ceremony.
My biggest letdown of the whole day yesterday, or on Sunday, I guess, was I didn't see any floppy wiener on Game of Thrones.
I didn't watch Game of Thrones.
Well, that's fine. I don't really watch it either, but all my buddies were watching right after Mania at my buddy's house. I was like, okay, I'll watch it.
Yeah.
Not a single floppy wiener.
I'm sorry. I don't know what to say to that.
South Park, because South Park.
Oh, I know. Oh, I know that.
Yeah,
so I'm not going out looking for floppy wieners just because I enjoy South Park.
They show a lot of
I'm just
frontal.
Saying, how, like, all I hear about is this show keeps showing all these wieners, and I didn't see one.
Count your lucky stars.
Yeah, I guess.
Well, not that I'm looking for it or not. It's just that it's That was my expectation, and then I didn't see it.
So there was boobs like 20 minutes in, though.
Yeah, there's a bunch of that.
Spoilers. I haven't watched it yet.
Well, now you will.
Well, I was going to anyway, but yeah.
I just feel like I've been lied to, is all.
Yeah. Thank you, Trey and Matt.
There you go.
You guys are fucked. You guys are fucked. All in all, everyone had a good weekend, though?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
How are you feeling, Gary? How's the old neck?
Terrible. I'm in a terrible place right now.
Uh-oh.
Each minute I sit at my desk, I get more sore.
Are you allowed to bring in, like, a cushion to sit on?
So I have a neck brace.
I know, but to sit on, so it's just kind of more comfort for you.
Pretend
you have hemorrhoids.
I never thought about that.
And you have, like, a donut or something.
I don't know if that would really help, but...
Just trying to make you more comfortable, bud.
No, I appreciate it.
No problem.
I wear a neck brace and everyone looks at me and laughs all day.
You tell them to fuck off.
Do you come in a wheelchair and then one day in a meeting, you know, just rip off the neck brace and stunner somebody?
That would probably be the greatest
thing
ever.
That would be pretty rad.
I would like to do that. But, yeah, to answer your question, I feel terrible and it's getting worse by the day.
Love to hear it. Awesome. Awesome. Sounds good.
My spirits are up. I'm not letting it bring me down.
It sounds like it, and that's the first step, Gary.
Yeah, I hear that.
Positivity leads to positivity.
Wow.
If you need help, I know a woman that talks to the richest people in the world about books.
I never thought I would hear you say anything that positive, ever.
I always say positive things. You're a fucking dick for saying that.
I'm just saying.
Scotty Ray of fucking sunshine.
There it is. That's the shirt I'm going to wear tomorrow.
That would be a sweet shirt.
Yeah, a picture of a Care Bear with your face.
A Gare Bear.
A Gare Bear.
Gare Bear, sure. A picture of your face on my body shooting a rainbow out of your tummy. I would definitely wear that.
Can we switch it up? I don't want it to be a rainbow. I want something like fun and cool.
Like what?
So now
like,
you're gonna
like
be
a power
like,
bomb? I don't know.
Sound wave, and you're going to have like a little cassette ejecting out. It'll be Gary shooting out of you.
See, that's the Gary. Man version of what I just said.
There you go.
Gary
perfect.
Eject.
Oh, man. But what? Here's the big question. What cassette would it be coming out?
Oof. I'd have to go with probably one of the first cassettes I ever remember purchasing.
Celine Dion?
No.
My Heart Will Go On.
Oh, God, I wish.
The opera soundtrack?
No, it was Bon Jovi, Slippery When Wet.
Oh, yeah. That's a winner. Yeah.
Bobby Brown, My Prerogative was mine.
Mm.
I think my first one ever was Tony, Tony, Tony that I got for free from work.
Oh, wow.
Work that you did when you were a kid.
Yeah.
School.
Yeah.
No, from school. Like elementary. So, Tony, Tony, Tony.
Nice, nice.
Yeah.
That's fun. Hey, what do you guys want to do in the next segment?
I want to have fun.
Okay. I want to pick up on something we discussed last week then for the next segment.
That sounds fun.
It does. Oh, trust me, it does. Get your thinking caps on and your dicks out because you're fucking fleshlights.
Wow. Scott, you're in tuck mode right now.
You're vulgar.
I'm just kidding. We're not gonna fuck fleshlights.
Oh,
but
my Lord.
Maybe it'll be fleshlight themed.
Oh boy.
Well, do you want to go glory hole, Gary?
Well,
oh, don't say that. Take that out of the tape, guys. That's not where I wanted to go.
I just want to have fun.
Perfect. All right, we're gonna take a quick break. When we come back, we're gonna have fun. Stay tuned. We'll be right back after these words.
You may value your privacy, but John Hunter doesn't. He wants to install a camera in your bedroom, so every time you jerk off, you have to pay $5. John Hunter voted to lower the marriage age down to 13. He wants to put your family at risk by outlawing 60 caliber full-auto assault rifles and domestically owned landmines. Call John Hunter. Tell him it's time to stop with the politics and the negative campaign ads. Tell him you're going to vote for Michael Graves for governor. Then call him a fat, bald prick and hang up the phone. Paid for by Michael Graves for governor.
Because the tears on your face, they can leave a trace.
Welcome back to The Nightmare with ScottyVia. I am your host, ScottyVia. Again, follow me on Twitter, at ScottyVia. That should be burning your brains by now, you guys.
SV cubed.
Yes? Cubed?
Is it cubed? Isn't that the little three?
Isn't cubed two?
No, that's squared.
What's cubed?
Three.
Yeah.
No?
Really?
That's...
What do I look like, a fucking mathlete?
Yeah.
I don't have my grade 12 math, so I don't even know.
Squared is two.
Uh-huh.
Yeah. Cubed is three.
Oh, I thought cubed and squared were the same thing.
No.
Well, a cube and a square. Is a cube's a fucking square, right?
No.
Oh, well, three is cubed because it's 3D. I get it. Perfect.
Are we okay?
Boom, boom.
The more you know.
That was a nice little break. You guys, did you get all freshened up during the break or anything?
I did. I brushed my teeth.
Wow.
Actually, no, I didn't. That's a straight up lie. I'd hate to lie to all our listeners here, but...
No,
I'm clean. I'm ready.
So I have two things, actually. One's going to be a game. We're going to do that in a minute. Not necessarily a game, but just a fun activity for you guys. But I was like, well, in case we need to fill time, I threw it out on the old Twitter and Facebook. What should we talk about on the show? And we got a couple of replies.
Uh-oh.
So I figured we've did this before, haven't we, guys?
Yeah,
so I figured
Are we interacting with the audience?
Like, we're interacting with our podcast audience.
That's so fun. I'm so happy people finally replied to you. I know that was a real issue back in the day before we got huge. So
on Twitter, this one's from Sarah. She said, you should talk about the nutcases you attract, which we did in the first segment. So thank you, Sarah. Those are not my words, mystery waitress. Not my words. That's just what was said. This one is from Princess Consuela.
Oh, that's a nice name.
That's a great name.
Yeah.
I believe her last name is Banana Hammock. Anyway.
Of course.
I was going to suggest, this is what she said. I was going to suggest tits and ass, but I'm assuming you boys want to talk about something new, and T and A are old by now. And I replied, absolutely not. T and A.
Always has its place.
Love titties, love ass. If it bounces, I'm happy. That's my theory on fun.
Wow.
So I'm going to go over to the old Facebook here. Alex said, lightning round questions, I want to play. And I said, I need a little more time to come up with questions, because this is like 30 seconds before the show came back to air. So yeah, I don't have time for lightning round questions. Maybe next week we'll do a series of questions.
Make sure you put that up beforehand then, hey?
Look, guys, I'm flying by the seat of my pants. You're trying to put on.
For once.
That was all Stetts. That was all my boy.
I'm trying to put on a good show because you support him, Gary.
In everything he does.
Exactly. Uh-huh. Eat a dick.
I love you, Care Bear.
Okay, fine. You know what? This is a legitimate response. It's on my Facebook, so feel free to read it. It says, why does Gary seem to know everything about picking up women, but he's still single?
Oh, snap.
Oh. Calls it out.
You know what the answer is to that?
Go ahead.
I know everything there is to know. That's why I'm single.
Ah, zing.
Yeah, I don't need my life ruined by one woman or numerous women. I have enough issues already. it's an ongoing issue.
Is Satan doing okay?
Oh, just girls are just the worst sometimes, you know?
What's going on?
Oh, nothing. It's just...
Something's going on if girls are all of a sudden the worst.
Well, no, I've always said that. That's like my moniker.
What's been going on lately?
Here lies Gary Nickel. Girls are the worst.
What's been happening lately?
Oh, nothing. It's just girls try to... You know, the first... Here you go, guys. Here's some knowledge about to get dropped on you.
Excellent.
If you ever wonder if a girl really likes you, you'll know once they figure out everything that pisses you off and uses it constantly on you. I have a bunch of girls that like me, apparently.
Okay.
So these girls are constantly trying to just bring me down because they know it gets to me.
What do you mean, bring you down?
Well, let's just leave it at that.
No! Okay, so they like you, but they're trying to bring you down? I don't get
because
that.
They like me.
So they're basically pulling your pigtails?
Exactly.
Do you know why, though?
Well, yeah, because they like me and they want me to... be in a relationship, and so I don't like relationships, they pull my pigtails.
Okay, so now I'm getting it straight. So they like you, they want to be in a relationship with you, but you're like, you know what, I'm just not feeling it right now. So they're like, you're a fucking asshole, Gary. Is that kind of the situation, but maybe not in those exact words?
No, not like that at all, but sort of.
Not like that, but sort of.
If that makes sense.
Okay, so instead of saying you're a fucking asshole, they're like, I don't want to talk to you today, or I don't want to hang out, or...
They do the things that they know will get under your skin.
Like what? Give me just Indulge me. Just give me one example.
One little example?
Yeah, just something that gets under your skin that one of these women have done to you.
Okay, being unappreciative of all the nice things you've done.
Mm-hmm.
And being angry at you for one thing you didn't do, totally forgetting all the awesome stuff that you've done for them.
So the one time you had to say no, they got pissed off.
Pretty much.
Okay, I get you now.
It's way, way, way deeper than that.
Yeah, but no, that's all I wanted. It was just a little example of what you're talking about.
Yeah, man, there's so many awesome girls out there, and then once they realize how awesome they are, and they start to flex, if you will,
mm-hmm.
once a girl starts flexing, get the hell out of there, basically.
Yeah, I mean, that makes sense. Yeah, I understand that. Steps. Yeah.
It's as simple as that.
Rick, simple.
And they want you to delve into their game and play the game with them and, you know, get all this and all that over this and that. And it's, when you don't do it, they pour it on. And it's just sad, really. It makes me sad.
You okay?
I'm fine. This ain't my first rodeo, brother.
Can I ask, are any of these women someone that, if they didn't play these games, that you would want to get into a relationship with?
That's a great question, and I don't know the answer because that's never happened.
Oh, okay. Say a woman doesn't want to play these games but actually likes you, and you like her.
Yeah.
Can I ask if the right situation approach itself, say this week,
okay,
would you be willing to get into a relationship with someone, or is this just something completely shut off for you for right now?
You never say never, Scotty. We're all hopeless romantics, but...
True, but...
Let's take it one day at a time.
So that answer is inconclusive.
The answer is I don't know.
Okay. Well, okay.
Do all parties know about one another?
That's a no.
Maybe. I don't know.
Okay.
It makes my head hurt just thinking about it, guys. You know?
No, I hear you. Okay. I've been in similar situations.
And by no means am I trying to sound cocky or...
No.
Like brag or anything, because that's not what I'm doing. I'm just trying to relate my experience to you guys.
Absolutely. You're trying to help out Brother Scotty.
Yeah. So.
All right, cool. I just want to make...
Good tangent.
Yeah. Okay. Well, do you want to do something fun, you guys?
Yes.
We talked about it in the first segment. I asked Gary if he would ever fuck a fleshlight. I also brought that up on last week's show. I also mentioned a glory hole, but again, he danced around it.
And I always dance because remember, I'm the good guy of this crew.
Yes.
I'm not the bad boy.
Okay. Well, I need you to be a good guy with this, but I also need you to play along.
Okay.
I need you and Corey. I have a stopwatch here.
Okay.
I'm gonna say minimum 20 seconds, but maximum 30 seconds. I need at least 20 seconds from you. I would like you, off the top of your heads, to come up with a very creative, attention-grabbing commercial for a fleshlight.
Oh, wow.
I need you to give me a 30-second spot on a fleshlight. You can call it whatever you want.
Yeah, no, I got this, man. That's easy.
You got it? Okay, well, then you're going to go first, then.
Lead off.
Corey, I will let you think about this.
I'll bet clean up, as it were.
Oh, gross. On a fleshlight? Disgusting.
Mm.
Oh, yuck.
It's like a freeze. You have to get all the way to the top to the bottom.
Oh, man.
So yeah, are you game?
Yeah.
Of course you are. You don't have a choice.
This is easy.
Okay. Are you ready?
Yeah.
Okay. On your mark. Get set. Stopwatch is starting right now.
Hello, everyone. My name's Gary Nickel for Fleshlight. Have you ever been lonely? So lonely that you've just thought, you know, nothing's going to make me happy anymore. Girls are the worst. Well, have I got the deal for you. The Fleshlight. Not talk. All rock. All you gotta do is whip out your, you know, and have a little fun. It's not for the whole family, but it's for you and your friends if you want, if you're like my friends, but that's a whole nother story. So if you want to have fun, all alone or with your friends, give Fleshlight a try. I did.
Nice, man. That was almost like, that was...
Well done.
30 seconds on the nuts, almost.
30 seconds on the nuts.
Oh, man.
Great job.
The stuff you make me do.
Oh, that was very, yeah.
That was
good.
Yeah.
Corey, are you ready?
And now for the X-rated version.
I'm ready.
Are you ready?
Okay.
All right, go.
Big interview coming up. Big date coming up. You want to go out prepared and not fully charged. The Fleshlight is here to help out for all your needs. With a quick slip of the dick, you'll be on your way to Happy Town. Picture this, if you will. You're at the club, music banging, boom, 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 boom. and you don't get the girl. Go home happy with Fleshlight.
Love it. Love it.
Oh, man.
Not as good as, you know.
That was way better than mine.
No, man. The whole time I'm thinking, like, okay, I can do an infomercial or something. And like, no, then this just came out, literally.
Man, I'm not going to lie. I'm a little surprised. That went really well. You guys are great thinkers.
You're working with some really creative fellas.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
That's what usually happens.
We had the PG version. I'd almost go G. Like, that was pretty general, right?
I was trying.
Yeah, you did a really good job.
I thought you were going to whip out the... and you didn't.
You know. I was waiting for, like, someone to do, like, a...
Well, you want
to
join in? You want to give your 30 seconds?
No. No. God, are you kidding me? This is my show. No. But I was waiting for someone to give, like, a user review. Like, we asked Jimmy what he thought. Hey, Jimmy, how do you feel about fucking a Fleshlight?
It was like putting your dick into a Ziploc bag full of Legos. It feels great.
Something like that. I don't know.
A Ziploc bag full of Legos.
There you go.
That's a visual and a half.
Oh, man.
It sure felt great, mister.
Great job, guys. Way to give 110%.
I told you. Bring it.
We're all in.
Wow.
Bring it over here.
Would you ever get a blocko pussy?
What
the hell is that?
It's like it's just
like a real doll,
but just the pussy part of a real doll. Like, it's literally just like stumps and a mold of a porn star's vagina.
No, that's
or butthole. They do buttholes as well.
No, that's no good.
How is that any different from a Fleshlight?
Well, it's totally different because it actually looks like a body, but it's missing limbs.
Yeah,
it's just like the pelvic area.
Yeah,
that's it.
That's not good.
That's like serial killer esque.
Yeah, that's creepy.
Yeah,
that's
curious.
Creepy and weird, man.
Just curious. Yeah. All right, cool.
Are you offended? Did we offend you because you own one?
I don't own one.
Wow.
According to you guys, I have a micro penis, so it wouldn't even fit. But I don't have a micro penis.
Hey,
I'll state that again.
If they're customizing stuff like this, I'm sure they can make one to fit your micro penis.
Yeah, it's called a thimble. Yeah, all right, see? And I don't have to worry about that either.
Okay.
Holy shit, we have fun on this show, you guys. I don't know, how are we not famous?
It comes with time.
This is show 24.
With great power comes great responsibility, Scotty.
There it is.
That's why I planned an amazing show, super responsible. Mm. We talked about Mania, we talked about our weekends, we talked about you guys fucking Fleshlights, we talked about a lot of things. Gary's multiple women issues.
And that's not all at the same time, by the way. Like, they come and go in and out of your life.
What, the women issues or the pocket pussy?
Both, I guess. Really want to get into it.
Do you have a lady on the go right now?
Yes.
Go on.
Well,
do you have more than one lady on the go?
No.
Excellent.
That sounded like a yes to me all day.
No.
No?
I'm just trying to sound cool on the radio. I got girls all over the place, man.
But you do have one, technically, as you said, on the go. Correct?
Sort of, yes. But
okay,
it's not a relationship.
So it's a fuck buddy situation.
Well, I like to call it more of a companion situation.
Okay. Do you guys cuddle more than you stick it in each other?
We enjoy each other's company.
Okay.
She's your Virgil, your valet.
There you go. Minus all the racist, you know, undertones. Yeah.
She's your Sable. There you go. You're Mark Mero. She's Sable.
The wild man.
There you go.
How long has this been going on?
Hold on. When we were watching Mania, Sable came up when Brock came out, and we were talking about Mark Mero. I was like, I bet he's dead. Have you seen what Mark Mero looks like now? It's weird, hey?
Yeah.
That's what happens when plastic melts.
Yeah, exactly right.
He's not dead, so that's better than... Well, I don't know. He looks pretty rough.
Yeah.
Either way. Yeah, steroids.
That too, yeah. Yeah.
Is that where you got your micro penis from, Scotty?
From Mark Mero?
No, from the juice.
Do I look like I've taken anything besides Kool-Aid as far as juice goes? No.
Tahiti treat?
No, that doesn't give me a bigger penis or a smaller penis.
Well,
it gives me diabetes. That's what it gives me.
If you put Extends in there, you'd have a bigger wiener, I think.
No, I don't think so. Is that how it works?
I don't know. I've never indulged.
That's what Scotty's going to do for the weekend. That's his homework.
I've got popsicle sticks. I'm good, you guys.
Put some Extends in your Tahiti treat and let us know if it works.
Is that what is that?
Extends?
Yeah.
Well, we've talked about this numerous times on the show. Do you not pay attention?
Yeah, he's
look,
not always
I cut
here.
Out a lot of what you guys say.
Yeah, fair enough.
Poke and shit.
That's getting bleeped out, so I don't know why you'd even bring it up. Only one of two phrases that I have banned. So, whatever.
I just like throwing out the challenge.
Just no, you're just making me do more work. That's I gotta bleep that shit out after.
I've never played poke before. You guys know that?
Really?
Yeah.
That's because you're an adult male. That's good.
Okay.
How about like the Super Nintendo?
Yeah, no, I never got into it.
Me neither.
Going around taking pictures of
that's
and stuff.
That's getting bleeped out.
No,
too.
I do know who two is though.
Yeah.
You're gonna piss off all of our listeners.
Why don't you bring a into the shower with you? He might you.
Now you guys are fucking perverts.
Well, that's just a great joke. That's all that is. If this is a stand-up stage, the crowd would be going nuts.
You think so?
Oh yeah. Two humor always wins.
Absolutely.
From what I've learned. You got a lot of editing to do.
I know, I'm very upset right now.
The flow will still sound great, even with the edit, so you're lucky there.
Every time someone says the word flow, I get sad.
Because you have no flow?
I have no flow.
I got sick flow.
And that makes me jealous.
You do?
Corey, yeah. You have a sick flow.
You know, I like to be trendy. I like to be trendy with my hair.
Yep.
It looks good.
Thank you.
Me? Crying on the inside all day.
Why'd you stop shaving it?
Because then you might happens. As well just start calling me Patches.
Or just wear a Hogan bandeezy.
A bandana and a weave in the back?
Yeah.
Shit.
Nothing wrong with that.
I can't wear that at work.
Sure you could.
I'm trying to be taken seriously. I'm wearing my NWO shirt right now. For life.
Wolfpack or original?
Original. I don't do Wolfpack. That was embarrassing.
Wolfpack. No, it was not.
It was embarrassing.
Love the Wolfpack.
Like, thanks, Steph. You just make me so happy. Scotty, the Wolfpack was fantastic.
They were fantastic.
They were fantastic because they had a cool song,
yep.
And they had the right members,
yep.
Minus Conan.
You're probably just going to say when they bring out Odale.
That guy can fuck off. But no, original NWO all day.
That all led to the LWO, right? And then it just all went to shit there.
Yeah, the luchador world.
Yeah.
It's very upsetting.
All right.
It's been a fun show, guys. Super duper fun. Don't everyone get all fired up at once.
I had such a great time. I'm so happy to be here. I want to thank all my friends and my family for listening, you know, and giving me the opportunity to produce such a fantastic podcast. I really hope everyone appreciates it as much as we do because it's just a lovely time. So thank you to God as well for being my boy and Hazy. That's my speech.
Oh, it's very good.
I thought we were ending on a high note. I was excited, so I wanted to thank you.
Sorry, I didn't know you were getting a Blockbuster Award right there.
Yes, I will. After that.
Make sure you wear your seatbelts, kids. This is the nightmare.
Scotty's gone!